Hey guys, so today we will be taking a look at the new smartphone. It is the Galaxy S2 Plus. So it's a new Galaxy S phone, and I have over here my new Galaxy S2 Plus here on the right side, while I have my Galaxy S2, the legendary Galaxy S2 phone from Samsung, on the left side. We're gonna go ahead and take just a quick look here, compare and talk a little bit about what is different with the Galaxy S2 Plus compared to the Galaxy S2, and why you might wanna consider picking it up. So, this is kind of interesting. If you look at these two phones, you can't see that of a big difference. The thing that you will notice is that there are some different colors here with the new Galaxy S2 Plus. But overall, screen technology, camera, a lot of things are the same. You cannot see they have exactly the same form factor, exactly the same kind of thickness. It's kind of funny. So, why did Samsung release a Galaxy S2 Plus? What is better with the Galaxy S2 Plus? Well, the big thing here is that it's using a different GPU, which is the GPU is basically the thing that you use when you watch or when you play a lot of games. So I haven't tried this out, but I will be doing more gaming videos in the future comparing these two devices. But the Galaxy S2 Plus is using a Broadcom video core IV GPU, while of course the Galaxy S2 here on the left side is using Samsung's own Mali 400 MP GPU, that they are the same GPU as they're using in the Galaxy S3, Galaxy Note 2, but it's overclocked in those variants. Also, you know, the chipset technology is the Broadcom one over here, Broadcom BC28155, I think it's being called, on the Galaxy S2 Plus. While it is the Samsung's own custom-made chips, they call Exynos, that they have in the Galaxy S2. You know, speaking about performance here, you can't really say that there is a big difference. We will, though, take a look at some cool things. We will be taking a look at the benchmark test, and inside a benchmark test, we will see which one who is the best. In terms of GPU, so we'll be using AnTuTu benchmark test to go ahead and compare the score on these two babies. So the latest AnTuTu benchmark here, and then we'll finally see which one has a better performance. So why don't you just go ahead and run a AnTuTu benchmark test. Wait a second. Okay, we will do that later. But that's kind of like the big things, that the GPU and the chipset is different inside of the Galaxy S2 Plus. Also, the processor, it's only 1 GHz dual core in the Galaxy S2 Plus, while it's a 1.2 GHz dual core here in the original Galaxy S2. The battery is the same, the kind of the screen is the same, so it's kind of interesting. And you might say, well, it's only 1 GHz dual core and 1.2, it's better on the Galaxy S2. Well, it's not just all about the numbers, it's also about the experience. I tried out some apps and opened them and closing them, and it was quicker on the Galaxy S2 Plus. But then we will see, you know, really when I make that benchmark test, which one is the best. It also is a little bit heavier, the Galaxy S2 Plus, a few grams extra. And you might also do enjoy the new color, the blue kind of color theme. And I think it's also available in another color. This is also one very big thing. It comes straight out of the box with latest Android 4.1 Jelly Bean, and it's rocking TouchWiz 5. While I'm pretty sure this Galaxy S2 here, which is only rocking Android 4.0.4 ICS, it will get Android 4.1.2 Jelly Bean update pretty soon here. Samsung has officially said that it's going to come, or it's currently being rolled out as we speak to different regions of the world. Same with the original Galaxy Note. It's on its way, but right now when I'm doing this video, and if you don't like flashing and stuff like that, it is available here in the Galaxy S2 Plus. And you know, you get some more awesome cool features. But speaking about performance here, it's kind of the same on both. And here you can see when I go down like this, it also looks kind of the same. The reason is because I'm running Android 4.1 Jelly Bean here, I'm pretty sure, also because I flashed it myself. But most people will rock on Android 4.0.4 ICS. But here you can see I'm also rocking 4.1 Jelly Bean, but there's a ton of new things in Android 4.1 Jelly Bean. Like, we do have the Google Now, which is amazing. I use Google Now right now, and it knows where I work, it knows places close to me. Google Now is really, really awesome once you start to use it. It has product butter, which is making the UI so much more smooth here. And also, I did see that the Galaxy S2 Plus could have support for SD card up to 64 GB, while the list were only stating that 32 GB is available for the Galaxy S2. I do believe that you will be able to, or that you can use a 64 GB SD card here inside of the Galaxy S2. Also, one bad thing here about the Galaxy S2 Plus is it only seems to be available in an 8 GB variant. Same problem, same issue I had there with the with the Galaxy S3 Mini, and a very, very negative thing there. Also, I think that was also one thing that kind of sucked with the Optimus L9. And then we should remember that they cost around the same, so it's a little bit sad over there. Speaking about the camera also, I tried it out a little bit, and I think that the Samsung could have calibrated the camera maybe a little bit inside of the Galaxy S2 Plus. You don't get as much yellow colors, and now I should say I'm not a camera expert. But yes, that's just the small little thing that I did discover here, and something else that you might think about if you purchase this device. It's kind of interesting because these devices cost around the same. So, I mean, the big things here, of course, that I would try out here in some benchmark tests is going to be, is Broadcom chipset better than Exynos? Is the GPU video core IV that's well in the Galaxy S2 Plus, is that better than the MI-400 GPU here? Right now, I don't have access to do some or download some heavy games, but I'm definitely going to go ahead and do more gaming comparisons on the Galaxy S2 Plus, and we will see how the performance will be and all those awesome things. Now, let's go ahead and fire up the browser on these two devices, and let's see if we can go ahead and let's see if we can fire up a website over here. And now, I know that this is not maybe like a fair video, because right now, I flashed a custom, myself, I flashed Android 4.1 Jelly Bean here on my Galaxy S2, so it's not as good. And as you can see over here, when we are inside of the browser, we do have brightness turned up. Oh, we have some amazing light there. We have brightness on full over here, and let's go to the front page of The Verge. Speeds should also be about the same. Of course, these devices aren't the well in a 4G variant. What I like about the Verge website is that it has a lot of colors. But it really shouldn't be that of a big difference, because the screen technology is about the same. But they are running on different firmwares and different chipsets. I'm not sure if that can affect. Shouldn't though affect the screen technology. Let's see here if we can go ahead and load up the page. There we go. So, personally here, it feels like the official Galaxy S2 Plus 4.1 Jelly Bean firmware here has a lot better colors. White looks a little bit more white here, I think, personally, than the 4.1 Jelly Bean that I flashed for the Galaxy S2 over here. It actually looks better here on the Galaxy S2 Plus. See here, we can go ahead and go down. Of course, no poor experience on any of these devices. It's really, really hard to tell when we are here inside of the browser. Let's go ahead and try to do a loading test. But I think the colors looks a little bit better here on the Galaxy S2 Plus. There we go. Right now, actually, I think it looks way, way better here. It must just be that the official Android 4.1 Jelly Bean from Samsung has a lot better color calibration. Kind of looks horrible here when we are on the Galaxy S2, the original Galaxy S2. It looks way better here. White looks so much more white. So that's something that definitely is awesome. In terms, as I said there, in terms of loading speeds, they're both using my Wi-Fi here at home. But it seems like it's a little bit better here on the Galaxy S2 Plus. Now, if we, let's go ahead and let's try out the Kindle app. Let's check out some quick reading experience here. And we're gonna go ahead and pop up Amazon Kindle. And one more time here, white looks more white on the Galaxy S2 Plus. But they're both rocking on the same kind of screen, Super AMOLED Plus screen. So it just must be the firmware that it's currently rocking on. And we can go ahead and see that for ourselves. They're rocking the same PPI, And I'm pretty sure also that you can see it yourself that it looks better here on the Galaxy S2 Plus. White looks dope. And you can also see that the time is a little bit different on both these two devices. If we go to settings and go down to about device, we can see that the model number is GTI 910 5P, and Rocket and 4.1.2 Jelly Bean, 4.1.2 over here as well. And you can see when we also close out, exit and close out apps, it's a little bit quicker here on the Galaxy S2 Plus. Not a big deal though, not a big deal. And let's go ahead and try to fire up a game. And as I said, I will do more hardcore games in the future. There we go, white looks so much better here on the Galaxy S2 Plus. Loads up about the same. Oh way. Oh no. Way quicker than the Galaxy S2 Plus. Let's go ahead. Let's go and close. And I think it was a little bit, tiny bit quicker there on the Galaxy S2 Plus. So, is there a big difference between these devices? Well, we're about to find out right now when we will try out some Antutu benchmarking. And then, of course, I'm pretty sure I will do some more more gaming in the future. They're downloading the new version. Okay, sure. I have an old version here, it seems like, on the the original Galaxy S2. So I will download this quick little update, and then we'll be running a test here. And then it could also be nice to, you know, if you really need a phone right now, I would go with the Galaxy S2 Plus just because it's rocking the latest version of Android. I don't want to wait on stuff. I just really, really don't want to wait. And also it's kind of nice that it's a little bit more white. But then you might not like the blue color of the Galaxy S2 Plus that I have over here. So let's go and do this. Gonna go ahead. I need to stop saying that. But this test will try out CPU, memory, and basically anything. And we will get a little bit of a benchmark score here. People love benchmark comparisons and tests. And also, it could be a bad thing here also that you might want to know that there's only, it seems like, an 8GB variant of the Galaxy S2 Plus. Which sucks if you're into gaming, because you will not be able to install that many high-end games compared to a 16 and 32GB Galaxy S2. Which one is better? It is a lot about if you're a hardcore gamer. I would try out the GPU inside of the Galaxy S2 Plus in the future, do a ton of gaming videos, but it is the VideoCore IV Broadcom GPU that is inside the Galaxy S2 Plus. That's a big, big, big thing there that you might want to ask yourself. And the chipset could also be something that could be interesting to have a little bit more of a closer look at, the BC28155. But if you are not into that much gaming, then the Galaxy S2 Plus could probably be the phone for you, because you get the latest version of Android right now, and you get the latest version of TouchWiz, and then of course you have this SD card option, and if you only can have 32 and a 64GB one on the S2 Plus, then that could also be a big thing. And then that the camera could be a tiny bit better. They both seems to be rocking the same Bluetooth still. And same 2-megapixel camera there in the front. And same battery, as I've said earlier. And 5 grams heavier, the S2 Plus. I don't think most people will have a problem with that though. That's a small thing. Seems like the Galaxy S2 original one will finish up this test earlier. And also, if you have a recommendation on a specific app that I can use to try out the chipset a little bit more, please tell me that. Because I know that the GPU, I can try that out a lot with the with games. So we got a score here on the Galaxy S2, 10,166. And there we go. So the Galaxy S2 Plus, we now have it on paper that the CPU seems to be very, very identical here in terms of score. The GPU is actually lower, so the Broadcom Video Core IV is not as good as the MI-400 MP GPU on the Galaxy S2. And then also I think that the MI-400 GPU has a lot more gaming support in the Play Store, but I will research that a little bit more. RAM is also a little bit better here on the Galaxy S2. And then IO, I'm not quite sure what that is, that's something cool. But that's actually higher here on the Galaxy S2 Plus. So I'll still do more gaming videos and gaming comparisons. And also if you have any recommendation, if I can try out the processor, experiment with the chipsets, if you have any good app for that, please tell me that in the comment section down below. Which one is your favorite? And if you like this video, please leave a like. Hey guys, so today we will be taking a look at the new smartphone. It is the Galaxy S2 Plus. So it's a new Galaxy S phone, and I have over here my new Galaxy S2 Plus here on the right side, while I have my Galaxy S2, the legendary Galaxy S2 phone from Samsung, on the left side. We're gonna go ahead and take just a quick look here, compare and talk a little bit about what is different with the Galaxy S2 Plus compared to the Galaxy S2, and why you might wanna consider picking it up. So, this is kind of interesting. If you look at these two phones, you can't see that of a big difference. The thing that you will notice is that there are some different colors here with the new Galaxy S2 Plus. But overall, screen technology, camera, a lot of things are the same. You cannot see they have exactly the same form factor, exactly the same kind of thickness. It's kind of funny. So, why did Samsung release a Galaxy S2 Plus? What is better with the Galaxy S2 Plus? Well, the big thing here is that it's using a different GPU, which is the GPU is basically the thing that you use when you watch or when you play a lot of games. So I haven't tried this out, but I will be doing more gaming videos in the future comparing these two devices. But the Galaxy S2 Plus is using a Broadcom Video Core IV GPU, while of course the Galaxy S2 here on the left side is using Samsung's own MI-400 MP GPU, that they are the same GPU as they're using in the Galaxy S3, Galaxy Note 2, but it's overclocked in those variants. Also, you know, the chipset technology is the Broadcom one over here, Broadcom BC28155, I think it's been called on the Galaxy S2 Plus. While it is the Samsung's own custom-made chips, they call Exynos, that they have in the Galaxy S2. You know, speaking about performance here, you can't really say that there is a big difference. We will, though, take a look at some cool things. We will be taking a look at the benchmark test, and inside a benchmark test, we will see which one who is the best. In terms of GPU, so we'll be using AnTuTu benchmark test to go ahead and compare the score on these two babies. So the latest AnTuTu benchmark here, and then we'll finally see which one has a better performance. So why don't you just go ahead and run a AnTuTu benchmark test. Wait a sec. Okay, we will do that later. But that's kind of like the big things, that the GPU